What is up, everybody? It's Michael Bashi here. Another week, another vlog, and we're back at it again in the car. And I'm actually going grocery shopping, and I have a few things on my mind that I wanted to share with you guys. So I figured it's a perfect time for a vlog, or for this week's vlog, to share what I want to talk about. We usually go as a family when we go grocery shopping, but just you know, things changed, plans changed, and I decided to go by myself. And usually when I want to clear my head, I just want to think, actually, for me personally, I know it may sound weird to you, but going grocery shopping or just leaving the house, going for a drive, is how I clear my head and how I can think better. And also, I know I say this in almost every single video when I'm in the car, sorry if I'm not looking directly at you, I am driving, safety first, gotta pay attention to the road. So apologies up front for that. So here's what I want to talk to you about in this video. And I know I hammer a lot about this topic, which is advertising and traffic. And there is many, many reasons why I do this. But the reasoning behind this video and why I'm shooting another video about advertising and about traffic is because I need people to understand that advertising is an ongoing struggle. Essentially, you do set up your campaign and it runs on autopilot. Yes, I mean, as I'm sitting here in the car talking to you, I have traffic going to my sites. You know, my campaign is running, people watching my videos, whatever it is I'm advertising. Yes, it's on autopilot. But you always have to maintain your campaign. You always have to calibrate it, so to speak. You don't just leave it running and you never ever touch it, or, you know, mess with it, or, you know, tweak it or refine it. You're constantly refining it because there are so many options and so many things you could do with one form of a campaign. And you have so many different things you can edit and so many settings you can play with that could determine crazy outcomes with a campaign, which is some of the stuff I'm going to share with you in this video about the recent stuff I've been testing. So one of the campaigns that I've been running, and I talked about it in last week's vlog or the week before that, I'm not sure. Anyways, so it's this new campaign for one of my programs. I'm running a video campaign, a video ad, and I'm spending about, just, you know, I'm still testing before I scale. So I'm testing with $250 a day. I spent about it goes up to 260, 270 a day. But, and again, I'm just testing before I scale. I've been testing for a while. I test for a very, very long time, so you know. Anytime I test a brand new campaign, I test it for about 3 to 4 months, all right? Even if I'm getting crazy results, and the reason why I keep testing, here is why. Then this is just like a side note type of thing. The reason why I keep testing the crap out of any campaign I put together is because I want to test every single possibility and every single angle and every single number and every single conversion and every single variation and everything. I want to test it and make sure I see the stats and I see the results from every outcome. And the reason why I do that is because after I'm done testing and I start scaling, I never look back. I stop testing because I've gotten all the numbers that I am comfortably happy with, because I've tested the crap out of it for 4 months. So once I start scaling, I don't mess with the campaign no more. I don't edit, I don't touch anything. For the most part, like 90% of the times, I don't touch anything. And the reason for that is because once you start scaling to like $1,000, $2,000, $5,000, $10,000 a day on ad spend per campaign, your numbers start to get extremely crazy, that good luck optimizing a campaign once you're spending that much a day. And that's for my experience personally, because your numbers, the traffic, the leads, the conversions that are going to be coming in are going to be extremely like high volume numbers that you can't make one minor change without throwing everything off, because now you have the machine working on so many different cylinders because you have so much budget to spend that it's trying to get you the best results at the best rate possible. So you don't want to mess with it once it gets to that point. Anyways, that's a side note. I digress. I'm sorry. Back to the crazy stuff I want to share with you. So on the 24th of February, by the time you see this video, we're going to be well into March, okay? Today is the last day of February. I'm recording this, and it's going to go live on the Friday in which you're going to be seeing. I don't know what you're going to see this, but this is the Friday's vlog. Anyways, I digress once again. I'm sorry. So I ran a test that I started running it on the 24th of February. I ran it from the 24th of February till the 28th of February. But on the 24th of February, I did the change in my campaign for that specific campaign. I made the change around 3 or 4 p.m., so halfway through the day. So any stats and any tests I was conducting it from the 25th to the 28th, so this way I get real raw stats just based on that change. So the small little change that I did was this. Prior to that time, when I started this campaign, I was getting crazy lead conversions, like $2-3 a lead, which is unheard of. For some reason, people resonated with the video ad, and I was getting like $2-3 conversions, which is crazy. The conversions I'm used to, like the industry standard even right now, with how expensive advertising have gotten, you know, you're paying like minimum $7, $6, $7, $8, $10, $15, $20 a lead. Okay, that's normal depending on your market, your niche, how good your, you know, your campaign is, and you know, it's determined by many, many factors. But anyways, I was getting like $2-3 a lead, and it was amazing. It was converting like crazy. I was generating like 50 to 100 leads a day, 60-70 on average per day. And I just started running this campaign. It's unheard of. However, after a few weeks, after third and fourth and fifth week, the cost per lead started to gradually go up, which is common. It's normal. So I knew it wasn't going to last long. So it started at $2-3 per lead. Then it was going up to $4.60, $4.90, $5 and some odd cents, $6, $7. And then it basically, on an average, when you take the average collectively, it stopped at about $7.91, $7.92 a lead. And it kind of stayed there for the longest time, till this very, very day, which is really, really, really good, okay? However, I wanted to test other things, okay? So what I did was I tested two other variations of the video. I recorded two other videos, and I did two other versions, and they completely flopped. Both new videos tied at converting at about $17 to $18 per lead, which is more than double what the original one was doing. I only ran them for 4 days. I'm like, you know what? The stats are clear. People don't like these videos. So I took them off. So then I'm like, okay, my cost per lead prop. So now I went back to the original video and testing my numbers and my stats on the original video. So then I said to myself, okay, the cost per lead went up, obviously, over time. It's common because when you put up, for example, a new video ad, it's a brand new video, the market hasn't seen it yet. If it's a good video with a good offer, people are gonna convert because they wanna see what it's all about because they haven't seen it yet. After a few weeks, when they start to see your video more, your same video ad more often, I'm assuming less people will convert because they're used to seeing your video all the time now, and they're just gonna click on, you know, skip ad because they don't want to see it. So I'm like, okay, if the same people are seeing my video ad more often, and if that's the reason why it's not converting as well as it used to, why don't I limit the number of people that can see my ad per person per day? So then I went in and I'm like, okay, each person can see my video ad only once per day. So you can't see it more than once. So I'm like, okay, so maybe that will reduce the number of people that are seeing it. And my cost per conversion will go back down to, you know, $2, $3, $4. So I did that and I tested that from the 24th to the 28th. But then I only did it from the 25th to the 28th when I was conducting the, when I was analyzing the numbers, because I wanted just three full days of, you know, seeing the numbers for that change that I had made. So then I was looking at my stats today, okay, for that. That's why I was inspired to make this video to share what I've been doing with you. So when I was analyzing the stats today, and I saw that, I'm like, okay, how much I spent on the ads for the 3 days was about $400 lower, which sounds good, right? My, I generated 100 more clicks than the... So basically what I was doing is I was comparing the 3 days with the change to the prior 3 days before I had made the change. So 3 days here, 3 days here, and comparing 3 day stats with 3 day stats, which is too short to do any sort of like testing. But because I'm spending a lot and my campaign have been running for so long and it already has data to go off of, then doing a 3 day test on something very as simple as the view count per user per day, you can get away with doing a test for 3 or 4 days because you have data that your campaign is going off of. It's not operating on brand new data. It's operating off of data that it has already collected in the last several 7 to 8 weeks I've been running this. Okay, almost a couple months. Anyways, so I spent about $400 or $500 less. I think it was almost $500 less within the 3 days than I usually spend, which is good. I generated 100 more clicks than the prior 3 days, and I generated 49 more leads than the prior 3 days, at about 5 cents lower than what I generate the leads for. So basically, sorry, 5 cents more. So in the 3 days, I generated, so the prior 3 days to the test, each lead was at about $6.98. And then after the test, my cost per lead was at $7.04. So it went up 5 cents, which is not a big deal. But again, this is why I do these tests, because when you're working with larger volumes, when you're doing $5,000-$10,000 a day on ad spend, the 5 cents will make a dramatic difference in your bottom line. So that's why you gotta test. So my cost per lead increased by 5 cents after the change of limiting one view per user per day. Okay, so it went up 5 cents, and guess what? Here is the crazy part. Yes, I got more traffic. Yes, I generated 49 more leads, but the problem was I spent 5 cents more per lead, plus I generated half the sales than prior to the test. Sorry, the sun is in my eye. I'm just gonna park and then I'll continue this video. So I'm not busy trying to park and talking to you. Just bear with me for a few seconds, please, and thank you. So, yeah, so I literally generated, I didn't even break even. I generated half the sales I had generated. So here's the thing. Most people wouldn't know how to read the stats properly, and they would look at something like this and say, yeah, this worked. I generated 50 more leads and I spent almost half of my ad budget. However, what's your bottom line? How many leads you generate doesn't matter. How much sales you generated from the leads, from your traffic, is what matters. So yeah, prior to the test, I spent double on ads, but I also generated double the sales. Okay, with the change, okay, I generated more leads, but I generated way less sales. So then I knew that, okay, I need to revert back to running my campaign how it was running, okay, and not limit the one view per user per day. And then what now what I would do, because now I know with this same video ad, I can get $2, $3, $4, even $5 per lead, so I can bring it down. The problem is, I know what the issue is. The issue is people are seeing my ad too many times per day, so it's not converting as, so the cost per lead has gotten more expensive. So then I figured, what can I do to bring that down? So what I've just done, okay, and I'll share with you the stats on that because I have not ran it yet. I took that same video ad that's been doing very, very well, and I created different versions of it where I change the beginning and the ending a little bit on each variation. So it's the same exact video, the same message, almost the same length, but I change the beginning and the end, the beginning and the end, the background music, just to make it a little bit different. And now, and I created two versions. And now I'm gonna have those two versions run to see if, you know, it's a, you know, it's kind of like a brand new video, to see if I'm gonna bring my cost per lead down back to, you know, couple dollars a lead. And if that works, then I will have the stats to know that, okay, this is why this is happening, because people are getting too used to the same video, so they're converting at a lot less. So what I need to do is I need to run different videos that also do well to keep my cost per lead down. So now if this new test works, what then I would have to do is to test running all three of them at the same time, or running each version for 3 to 4 days and then pausing it, and then running a different one for 3 to 4 days, maybe even a week, pause it. So every week, let's say for example, I run a different video ad, and then I would keep it low. If that's the test that I conduct, if it's going to work, I don't have the results for it yet because I haven't tested it yet, but if that works, then that's what I'm gonna be doing. And then that's when I can basically start scaling from there, because now I know the trick, so to speak. So what's the point of me sharing this with you? Everything I walked you through, all the different tests I do, the different tricks, the different methods that I do from analyzing my numbers is what determines what I'm going to do next. You don't see me just throwing in the towel when something happens that I don't like, numbers I don't like, and I say, ah, this stuff is a scam, it doesn't work. That's what majority of people who are not born entrepreneurs do. They think the internet is this magic place where you just get on there and everybody's gonna buy whatever you put out, and you know, you're gonna get rich overnight. And I blame this not on the consumers or on people who are starting out, but I blame this BS on the so-called gurus who are selling this illusion that this is how the internet works, when it really, really doesn't. So then more and more people get the idea that this is how it works, and then when it doesn't work that way, they get pissed off, and then nothing works, and then everybody just gives up. The thing is, you need to work your behind off to make every part of your business work. Okay? What I offer you, the services, the training, the done for you, yeah, it's phenomenal. It's going to help you get a million steps ahead to your goal. But the problem is, this is just the help. You still have to make it work. Now imagine you did not have the done for you part of what I'm offering you. You would have just added another 2-3 years to figuring out and building and putting together what my done for you services are doing for you. So my done for you services are shaving time off of the collective time you would need to accomplish a goal. So it's a good thing. But then you also need to advertise, and you need to not necessarily advertise any aspect of the business, not just marketing and advertising, any aspect of it needs time, trial and error to figure it out. So I hope this video wakes most of you guys up, guys and gals, ladies and gents, and just realize that it's an ongoing battle. It's not something that's gonna happen 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. I've been doing this for 20 years and I'm still testing. Like, just think about it this way. Yes, I'm making money. I'm blessed. I'm grateful. It wasn't always like this. Struggled for 7 years, made nothing. I still have ups and downs like any other business. Okay, even Warren Buffett has ups and downs. Even Warren Buffett has businesses that lose money and businesses that make money. But then the businesses that make money carries those that don't, and vice versa. It's normal. Okay, there's no secret sauce. This is normal for everybody, for any business. Okay, but the secret sauce, so to speak, if you want a secret sauce, if you want a trick, the secret, the magic is you keep going. Consistency. You continue. You don't stop. You keep going. You keep going, not trying different opportunities every week. You keep going and you stick to the same business and you keep refining it and making it better. That's what I mean by you keep going. If you're going to start a brand new business every week, then nothing's going to ever work. Okay, I don't care what you do, nothing's going to work. You got to stick to one business and over time it's going to work. So, hope this video finds you guys well. Hope you learned a lot from it. Hope you loved what I shared with you guys. I got to go in shopping. I got half an hour before they close down. I don't need to get much, so it doesn't matter. So if you guys have yet to sign up for the discovery video to see how I could help you start your own solo ads agency, you'll find a link somewhere. Click on it, register, do check it out. It's a 20-22 minute discovery video that's going to show you what I do, what me and my team can do for you, how we could help you. Check it out. It's good stuff. I promise you're gonna love it. Also, if you enjoy my content at all, do comment and subscribe to my channel. It would mean a heck of a lot to me. I would appreciate it. I would love it if you do so. And you can go to my YouTube channel by going to youtube.com/MichaelBashi. You could comment there, subscribe, tell me how you feel, what you think, how you enjoy my content. If you do, hopefully you do. And help me grow this channel. I'm not that active on social. I'm way more active than I ever was before. Way more active now than I ever was before. And I plan to continue on doing that, hopefully. So please help me spread the word. I would really appreciate it. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, stay strong, stay consistent, stay blessed, build that business. I know you could do it. Anybody can, as long as you stay persistent and consistent and you don't give up at any moment or anytime something doesn't go your way. Okay? These are traits and habits you build. You're not born with them. So as long as you develop those habits over time, anybody can follow their dream and make it. So thank you so much for watching. God bless, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.